Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to Monte Bondone, which is a very famous road up here in the mountains. It's a beautiful road, very well kept, with a lot of curves. It is actually very funny, way too fun for many people, because they changed the speed limit to 60 km/h, because actually there were way too many road bikes on the street, so the locals were pretty angry at them. But nonetheless, it's a beautiful road, it's a beautiful landscape. But first we're gonna pass through Valle di Cavedine with a swooping amazing view over the Dolomites of Brenta, with the highest peak, Cimatosa. It's 3000 and something. So yeah, it's gonna be nice. Once again, we are in the Sarca Valley. It's a very, very famous place for German people. Actually, we get almost 50% of the tourists here are from Germany. Not a lot of tourists around in this part of the year, also because of the COVID-19, and also because it's the middle of October, so season is almost over. So we're just arriving in the little town of Drena, which is a tiny little village here, and the main attraction, it's that castle over there, beautiful castle. Behind it you see a huge mountain, which is Monte Brento, a very famous exit point, very famous worldwide for the ones who like extreme sports, like wingsuit flying. And that's the castle, amazing. It's a really, really beautiful castle. Let's wait for this car to pass, and here we are. So I don't have a lot of time today, so it's gonna be a quick motovlog. All these houses you see around, they date back to the 17th century. 17th, 16th century. Back when this place was not Italy, actually it was part of the Austro-Hungaric Empire, and became part of Italy after the First World War. You can also see in the architecture, it's, it reminds you of the northern countries. It's way more similar to Austria than it is to... Alright, here we are again. So I put my jacket on, my winter gloves. It's temperatures are nice. We have around 16, 17 degrees, so this time of the year in Italy is not so cold after all. But the leaves start turning yellow and brown. A lot of tractors. One of the main cultivation here is apples, small fruits like strawberry, and of course the main culture of Trentino is the vineyards. Oh, it's covered by the clouds. You can see the peaks. Yeah, so the Dolomites of Brenta, it's a shame you can see it today. I will pass it in this road in the next days, but all this part with the clouds is the Dolomites of Brenta. It's an amazing mountain range. Actually, they're protected by the UNESCO. This car has a pin in the back, which means he's taking the driving license. So I gotta be careful with these people. You never know what they're doing. So here we are back at it. Just realized I didn't not only close properly my jacket, but I didn't fasten my helmet with all this motovlog setup, which is very dangerous. Always check your gear before starting up the motorcycle. This is where the road to Monte Bondone starts. We are not gonna go all the way up to the mountain because today I have no time. My goal in this motovlog is to explore and to share with you guys the most beautiful parts of this beautiful country, which is Italy. It's so full of amazing place that even Italians don't know them all. We're gonna continue for a little more just to show you guys the amazing view you get from here. So as you can see, the asphalt, the tarmac is perfect. Not too many people around here. He did say hello and he drives an Harley. That surprised me. As you can see, I don't like to drive fast. I'm from the club of 80k per hour. So, let's go back. I love this setting, you know, beautiful roads, landscape is beautiful, there's nobody on the street. I discovered the motorbike less than a year ago. A friend of mine came along with the Honda XL300 and he made me try it, and it was like instant love. He made me try it in the woods and I was like, this is amazing. So what I did, I went, day after I went to the internet, start searching, and found out that there were so many people traveling the world with their motorbikes, and one of the best motorbikes you can buy for a fair price was the Honda Transalp. Its engine is really indestructible. So after a long search, I bought myself this black Honda Transalp 650. Paid it 3,000 euro. It had 50,000 K on it. People told me that this kind of motorbikes can easily do 200,000 K. Now we're gonna enter to this little town called Cavedine. Where this road is going? Let's see. Let's go to the adventure. So many leaves. See, it goes up, 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 up. Timpan gonna go back if it keeps going up. I don't know where it's going. And it's going to gravel. Let's keep on going for a little bit. Can see something. Alright, brings you to a field. Let's see what's in there. We're working. Oh, there is even a house here. Nice. What is this? Oh, it's an exhibition. Let's see. As I say, this place used to be Austria until the First World War. So there is a little exhibition here. Alright guys, so back at it. We're in this beautiful place. I really would like to go to explore there, but I think it's private property. Well, it's pretty obvious that it's private property, so I don't want to invade the field while there are people here. And come back next time. Let's go back. So that's the thing with the woods in this part of Italy. There are always people around, always. These woods have eyes. It rained a lot in the past few days, so the road is very slippery. Beautiful horses. It's a nice place for them. Oh, ships. And here we have the majestic view of Monte Brento. You can see down there Lake Garda, and below here Lake Cavedine. And if you can, yeah, I don't think it's a wise idea, so let's do it. Can you see the lake? This is Lake Cavedine. Such a beautiful view. I'm lucky to live in such a beautiful place. It's the good fortune to live where other people go on vacation and go back home from Lake Cavedine.